Hello students, I welcome you all to EPG Pathshala. Myself Professor Sambodh Kumar Swain, teaching in the Department of Tourism Management as a professor in Indira Gandhi National Tribal Institute, Amarkantak. Today, I will be speaking to you through a presentation on a very relevant topic. To understand role and contribution of global organization, namely important global organizations in tourism and hospitality. After completing this module, students will be able to learn the role of global organizations, vision and mission of organizations, contributions of organizations in tourism and hospitality, association of organizations for the growth of tourism and hospitality. Introduction. International travel, tourism and hospitality organizations play a major role in advancing the development through the interest of the industry. They provide forums for discussions of common issues, lobby for industry causes, especially those which promote the industry's interest, and allow members from different parts of the world to network and learn from one another. Nearly all organizations are involved in doing research, providing marketing services and training schemes that are most cost effective when done jointly under an umbrella organization, United Nations World Tourism Organization, UNWTO. The UNWTO is the United Nations agency responsible for the promotion of responsible, sustainable and universally accessible tourism. As the leading international organization in the field of tourism, the UNWTO promotes tourism as a driver of economic growth, inclusive development and environmental sustainability, and offers leadership and support to the sector in advancing knowledge and tourism policies worldwide. The UNWTO encourages the implementation of the Global Code of Ethics for Tourism to maximize tourism's socio-economic contribution while minimizing its possible negative impacts, and is committed to promoting tourism as an instrument in achieving the Sustainable Development Goals, SDGs, geared towards reducing poverty and fostering sustainable development worldwide. Functioning of UNWTO. The Secretariat is led by Secretary General, presently Taleb Rifai of Jordan, who supervises about 110 full-time staff at UNWTO Madrid headquarters. The General Assembly is the principal gathering of the World Tourism Organization. It meets every 2 years to approve the budget and program of work and to debate topics of vital importance to the tourism sector. The UNWTO has 6 regional commissions: Africa, the Americas, East Africa and the Pacific, Europe, and the Middle East and South Asia. The Executive Council is UNWTO's governing board, responsible for ensuring that the organization carries out its work and adheres to its budget. As a host country of UNWTO's headquarters, Spain has a permanent seat on the Executive Council. Specialized committees of UNWTO members advise on management and programs content. These include the Program and Budget Committee, the Committee on Statistics and the Tourism Satellite Accounts, the Committee on Tourism and Competitiveness, the Committee on Tourism and Sustainability, the World Committee on Tourism Ethics, and the Committee for the Review of Application for Affiliate Membership, World Travel and Tourism Council. The World Travel and Tourism Council, WTTC, was formed in 1991 by a group of travel and tourism CEOs to study the sector's contribution to economies and job creation. The WTTC is the only global body that brings together all major players in the travel and tourism sector. Bracket begins airlines, hotels, cruise, car, rental, travel agencies, tour operators, GDS and technology, bracket ends, enabling them to speak with one voice to the governments and international bodies. The WTO uses empirical evidence to promote awareness of travel and tourism's economic contribution, to expand markets in harmony with the environment and to reduce barriers to growth. It is important that WTTC has the broadest geographical representation and includes all aspects of the sector, including organizations that provide vital services to travel and tourism, with chief executives of over 140 of the world leading travel and tourism companies. As its member, the WTTC has a unique mandate and overview on all matters related to travel and tourism. The body advocates partnership between the public and private sectors, delivering results that match the needs of economies, local and regional authorities, and local communities with those of the business, based on governments recognizing travel and tourism as a top priority business, balancing economies with people, culture, and environment, a shared pursuit of long-term growth and prosperity. Research of WTTC. Economic research, it studies and publishes research on the sector's direct, indirect, and induced impact at a national, regional, and global level on jobs, GDP, and trade and investment. Policy research. A range of other research projects focused on issues impacting the travel and tourism sector related to the three strategic priorities of freedom to travel: policies for growth and tourism for tomorrow. International Air Transport Association, IATA, or IATA. The International Air Travel Transport Association is the trade association for the world's airlines, representing some 265 airlines or 83% of total air traffic. IATA was founded in Havana, Cuba on 19 April 1945. It is the prime platform for inter-airline cooperation in promoting safe, reliable, secure, and economic air services for the benefit of world's consumers. The international scheduled air transport industry is more than 100 times larger than it was in 1945. IATA is led by Alexander De Juniaca, Director General and CEO since September 2016. At its founding, IATA had 57 members from 31 nations, mostly in Europe and North America. Today, it has some 265 members from 117 nations in every part of the globe. The IATA is the successor to the International Air Traffic Association, founded in The Hague in 1919, the year of world's first international scheduled services. In April 2017, IATA celebrated 72 years of flying. IATA maintains an international perspective and provides a unique global voice on behalf of its members. With over 60 offices worldwide, IATA maintains relationships with governments and other industry stakeholders around the world, advocating on behalf of its members on key industry issues. Vision and mission. Vision: to be the force for value creation and innovation driving a safe, secure, and profitable air transport industry that sustainably connects and enriches our world. Mission: IATA's mission is to represent, lead, and serve the airline industry. Representing the airline industry, the IATA improves understanding of the air transport industry among decision makers and increases awareness of the benefits that aviation brings to national and global economies. Advocating for the interest of airlines across the globe and stopping unreasonable rules and charges, holding regulators and governments to account, and striving for sensible regulation are four important activities. IATA helps airlines to operate safely, securely, efficiently, and economically under clearly defined rules. Professional support is provided to all industry stakeholders with a wide range of products and expert services. IATA members. From 57 founding members in 1945, IATA now represents some 265 airlines in over 117 countries, carrying 83% of the world's air traffic. IATA members include the world's leading passenger and cargo airlines. IATA membership is open to airline operating scheduled and non-scheduled air services that maintain an IATA Operational Safety Audit, IOSA, registration. IATA airline membership benefits increasing communication, participation in member conferences, committees, and group offers, unprecedented access to a variety of airline and industry partners. The IATA annual general meeting and World Air Transport Summit brings together representatives from leading international airlines. IATA helps members gain influence with the travel agent community through the IATA agency program, providing key commercial services and training. IATA provides training in major fields such as passenger, cargo and safety. IATA programs help to strengthen the capabilities of aviation industry professionals. IATA members can receive discounts up to 30% on a member of IATA publications. International Civil Aviation Organization. The International Civil Aviation Organization, ICAO, is a UN specialized agency established by states in 1944 to manage the administration and governance of the Convention on International Civil Aviation, Chicago Convention. ICAO works with the convention's 191 member states and industry groups to reach consensus on international civil aviation standards and recommended practices (ASARPS) and policies in support of a safe, efficient, secure, economically sustainable and environmentally responsible civil aviation sector. These ASARPS and policies are used by ICAO member states to ensure that their local civil aviation operations and regulations conform to global norms, which in turn permits more than 1 lakh daily flights in aviation's global network to operate safely and reliably in every region of the world. In addition to its core work resolving consensus-driven international ASARPS and policies among its member states and industry and among many other priorities and programs, ICAO also coordinates assistance and capacity building for states in support of numerous aviation development objectives. It produces global plans to coordinate multilateral strategic progress for strategic and air navigation. It monitors and reports on numerous air transport sector performance metrics. It also audits state civil aviation oversight capabilities in the areas of safety and security. Vision and mission. Vision: achieve the sustainable growth of the global civil aviation sector. Mission: to serve as the global forum of states for international civil aviation. ICAO develops policies and standards, undertakes compliance audits, performs studies, analyzes, provides assistance and builds aviation capacity through many other activities and the cooperation of its member states and stakeholders. How ICAO develops standards? The establishment and maintenance of international standards and recommended practices ASARPS as well as procedures for air navigation PANS are fundamental tenets of the Convention on International Civil Aviation, Chicago Convention, and a core aspect of ICAO's mission and role. ASARPS, PANS are critical to ICAO member states and other stakeholders, given that they provide the fundamental basis for harmonized global aviation safety and efficiency in the air and on the ground the worldwide. Standardization of functional and performance requirements of air navigation facilities and services, and the orderly development of air transport. The development of ASARPS and PANS follows a structured, transparent, and multi-stage process often known as ICAO amendment process or standards making process, involving a number of technical and non-technical bodies which are either within the organization or closely associated with ICAO. Typically, it takes approximately 2 years for an initial proposals for a new or improved standards, recommended practice or procedure to be formally adopted or approved for inclusion in an annex or a PANS. Occasionally, this time scale can be expanded or compressed depending on the nature and priority of the proposal under consideration. United Federation of Travel Agents Association, UFTA, in the 1960s, At the dawn of mass tourism, a few tourism professionals with great foresight saw the need of a global umbrella organization for the travel agency industry. By merger of Federation International Des Agences de Voyages, FIAB, and Universal Organization of Travel Agents Association, UOTAA, the Universal Federation of Travel Agents Association, UFTA, was formed on November 22, 1966 in Rome. Its first president was an Italian, Giuliano Magnonani, later followed by 24 leading personalities from all parts of the world. The federation was later renamed United Federation of Travel Agents Associations, still known under the same well-established acronym UFTA. As a globally recognized body, UFTA is the largest established negotiating partner with the leading travel and tourism organizations in the world. Of a special importance is the close cooperation with IATA, representing the interest of individual travel agents and as partner in the IATA-UFTA training program. Two other organizations with a close relationship are the International Hotel and Restaurant Association, IHRA, and the International Road Union, IRU, also in areas which are more distant from the daily worries of travel agents, as UFTA actively been and still is a spokesperson for the agents' interest. Particularly worth mentioning are the World Tourism Organization, or UNWTO, through its affiliate member program, and at various occasions the World Health Organization, WHO, UNESCO, International Chamber of Commerce, ICC, International Forum of Travel and Tourism Advocates, IFTTA, and many more. The high-level contacts have enabled UFTA to assist national associations in their contacts with authorities, also to help individual agencies. Though its history, UFTA has been a faithful, active, and neutral advocate for all associations and independent travel agencies, irrespective of size and location. In the competitive environment of today, a neutral umbrella organizations like UFTA is needed more than ever before to defend and promote the interest of travel agencies in their professional work on behalf and for the traveling consumers. UFTA gets ready to celebrate its 50 years of successful contribution to the travel and tourism industry. UFTA offers to its membership the valuable opportunity to be involved with UFTA's networking global platform in order to support good health of travel and tourism industry. UFTA encourages associations, organizations, institutions, and individual member agencies in travel, tourism, and hospitality industry to get connected via UFTA mission. UFTA's mission is to be an international forum where matters affecting the world travel industry are addressed, representing and defending the interest of incoming and outgoing tour operators, travel and tourism agencies before the government bodies. Suppliers and other entities of international scope, it also aims at strengthening its members' image and enhances the world travel and tourism industry and a sustainable tourism. Functions of UFTA. To comply with its mission, the Confederation develops the following functions: to unite and consolidate the federations of travel agents, national associations, and to globally enhance the interest of their members. To represent the travel agents' activities before various worldwide bodies, governmental authorities, and suppliers, to work towards the adoption of measures that will ease travel for the consumer and to offer services to its member federations, to offer as a voluntary mechanism an arbitration service which assists in solving conflicts resulting from commercial relations for which amicable settlement cannot be reached, to organize a World Congress of Travel Agents and other meeting necessary to the exchange and transmission of knowledge. International and Hotel and Restaurant Association, IHRA, January 1869, 45 hotel men met together in Koblenz at Hotel Trier, Germany, and decided to create an alliance between them under the name of All Hotelman Alliance, AHA, to defend their interest, and they start to grow and get organized. Hotels were from different standards. April 1921, various local European, African, Latin American Hotels Association met together and decided to merge into a new international association. It becomes International Hotels Alliance, IHA. November 1947, after the end of the Second World War and the creation of the United Nations, hoteliers from International Hotels Alliance met together with the European Aubergistes Association and the Asian Innkeepers Association decided to merge into a large international association to defend the private sector worldwide forum from governments, public sectors, military, etc., and create International Hotel Association, IHA, in London. The IHRA is the only international trade association exclusively devoted to promoting and defending the interest of the hotel and restaurant industry. And worldwide, it is a non-profit organization and is officially recognized by the United Nations. IHRA monitors and lobbies all international agencies on behalf of the hospitality industry. Who are its members? International, national and regional hotel and restaurant associations, international and national hotel and restaurant chains, owners, developers and investors, individual hotels and restaurants, institutions of the industry, hotel schools, educational centers, universities, students, independent hoteliers and restaurateurs. What does IHRA do? Monitor issues that are raised by major international organizations involved in tourism. Represent the collective industry interest before policy makers. Lobby for better recognition of the hospitality industry worldwide. Lobby against damaging or costly attempts to regulate the industry. Create global councils around industry issues to debate positions and create solutions. Listen to its members to ensure that all issues are addressed. Plan a series of informative council and board meetings and an annual congress. Provide support where requested to lend weight to local and regional issue. Advocacy. As the only international trade association devoted to protecting the interest of the global hospitality industry, the International Hotel and Restaurant Association's role is to monitor, research and, where possible, preempt the passage of regulation taxation at the national, international level when this is deemed to run contrary to industry interest. The representation work involved in doing this terms advocacy is that advocating or defending the interest of a specific sector before public and sometimes private sector decision making bodies. Why to undertake advocacy? The travel and tourism explosion of the last three decades has focused government attention on the hospitality sector as never before, bringing to in its wake a surge of new regulation and taxation. Although laws are enacted at national level, they frequently have their genesis in international agencies, principally those of the United Nations, which have seen their role and mandate expand exponentially in recent decades. As a result, advocacy or lobbying to promote and defend the hospitality industry's interest has been repeatedly stressed by chain and national association. Chief executives within IHRA are the activity that constitutes their major expectation of membership. As a membership-driven association and the voice of the industry, IHRA must be vigilantly proactive in protecting the global interest of the hospitality industry. It represents, to do this, it is essential to monitor, research, and even more importantly, forecast the issues of concern and importance to its members and the industry at large. Pacific Asia Travel Association PATA, founded in 1951. The Pacific Asia Travel Association PATA is a not-for-profit association that is internationally acclaimed for acting as a catalyst for the responsible development of travel and tourism to, from, within the Asia and Pacific region. The association provides aligned advocacy, insightful research, and innovative events to its member organizations. Comprising 95 government, state, and city tourism bodies, and 29 international airlines, airports, cruise lines, 63 education institutions, and hundreds of travel industry companies in Asia Pacific and beyond. Since 1951, PATA has led from the front as the leading voice and authority on travel and tourism in the Asia Pacific region in partnership with private and public sector members. PATA enhances the sustainable growth, value, quality of travel, tourism to, from and within the region. PATA's Strategic Intelligence Center, SIC, offers unrivaled data, insights including Asia-Pacific inbound and outbound statistics, analyses and forecasts, as well as in-depth reports on strategic tourism markets. PATA's events create millions of dollars of new business each year for its members. The PATA Foundation contributes to the sustainable and responsible development of travel and tourism in Asia and Pacific through the protection of the environment and the conservation of heritage and support for education. PATA chapters. PATA chapters are established throughout the world to assist in the fulfillment of the objectives of association, their local community, organizations of travel, industry and professionals who join in a cooperative endeavor within the framework of PATA to develop travel and tourism to, from and within the Asia-Pacific area. There are 40 PATA chapters around the world that make valuable contributions to local travel industry communities. Summary. International Travel, Tourism and Hospitality Organizations play a major role in advancing the development through the interest of the industry. They provide forums for discussions of common issues, lobby for industry causes, especially those which promote the industry's interest, and allow members from different parts of the world to network and learn from one another. The UNWTO promotes tourism as a driver of economic growth, inclusive development, and environmental sustainability, and offers leadership and support to the sector in advancing knowledge and tourism policies worldwide. The WTC uses empirical evidence to promote awareness of travel and tourism economic contribution and to expand markets in harmony with the environment and to reduce barriers to growth. The IATA improves understanding of the air transport industry among decision makers and increases awareness of the benefits that aviation brings to national and in global economies. Dear students, all these international apex bodies that I have presented before you must have clarified many of your inquisitiveness and interest to know how these bodies play a critical role in promoting and developing tourism all over the world. More importantly, the UNWTO and other organizations, they have been working in tandem to make tourism a global industry, and they have become successful. With this, I would like to conclude this presentation with thanks.